Different views of how, you know, the attitude that we have towards God. If he's a provider, we shall take him as our provider.
Amen.
If he's a counselor, we take him that way as our counselor. Hmm. If he is our healer, the promise keeper of who God he is, we have to take him just the way he is. Amen.
Amen.
So, yeah, it's something that we rejoice. It's something that we should have delight in. It's something that pleases God, because God loves his children. God loves us. Nice. So even if we have come in one accord to worship him, God blesses us.
Amen.
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 Let's come into his presence just now and just worship, ask God, whatever, anything that we want, anything that is pressing upon our hearts, you know, anything that we are desiring. Amen.
Amen.
Because our God never fails. Our God will never leave us nor forsake us. We have to rejoice in him. We have to be so delighted. We have to be so delightful in doing his will. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Let's just praise him. Let's just thank him. Let's just worship him. Amen. Father, we thank you this afternoon. We want to thank you just as we are. We exalt your name for faithfulness. We thank you because you are God. We thank you because you are Father. We thank you because you are
Father.
We worship you because you are Father.
To give us life. Father, we adore you tonight. We reference you, O God. We honor you tonight. We honor you tonight. We bless your name, King of Glory. We bless your name, O God. 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 He was like unto thee, O God. He was like unto thee, O God. Father, I give you the praise. You are beauty in holiness, O God. You are fearful in praise, O God. Mighty Father, we exalt you, mighty Father. We exalt you, mighty Father. We bless your holy name. 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 We can compare with you, O God. There is none. There is none. There is none, O God. We honor you tonight. We honor you tonight. We honor you, we honor you, O God. They are worthy, O God, to be responsible before thee, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we come with our worship tonight to you, O God. We say, let your name be exalted, let your name be exalted, let your name be exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. We come, O God, just the way we are, O God, to your throne tonight, O God. Let your name be exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We are so sick in the glory. We are so sick in the
Thank you, Jehovah God. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. Thank you. Thank you for who you are. Thank you, Jehovah God. We give you the praise.
We give you the opportunity
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you for another mercy.
Thank you, mighty God, for your mercy. Thank you. Thank you.
On our lives today.
Thank you, mighty God. Mighty God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Jehovah God.
Thank you,
mighty God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah God. We worship you. We worship you, Hallelujah.
Amen.
Another message I'm going to share is in Exodus chapter 1. Exodus chapter 1, verses 18 to 20.
Isaiah chapter number 1, verse 18.
18 to 20.
The Bible says, Isaiah chapter number 1 and verse 18 to 20, the Bible says, "Come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins are as like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be as white as wool. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land."
Amen. When I looked at this scripture, it's like a stain, you know, this scarlet and the crimson. It's like a stain when it goes on a like a cloth. It makes a stain. Even if when you want to take it out, it won't come out. It comes like a permanent. It sticks there. But God is saying, "Come, let us reason together." God doesn't look at the sin. God is interested in each one of us. And we're willing and obedient. So the key point there is, if we are willing and obedient, it is an invitation to all of us. Even if our sins are red as and crimson, but God inviting us, come, it's an invitation.
Hallelujah.
It's not looking at any sins that we have committed, anything that is shunning away from God. God is a faithful God. He's calling each one of us, come. His wise hands wide open. He says, come, just as you are, come. Come, let us reason together. Because we are weak, we cannot do anything without God. That's why he's inviting us to his presence to say, come to me. Come, let us reason together. How do we reason together? The way we have come in the presence of God, the way we are, we have come in his presence. We have come to dwell under his presence. And we are asking God that, Lord, help us. And he's there. He's already invited us. It is our willingness and our obedience that is the one that is determined. Because if we are not willing and if we are not obedient, then we won't reason together with God. He is a faithful Father. He's calling every one of us to come to him, and we can reason together with him. Amen. We cannot do it on our own. We don't have any strength. We don't have any powers. That's why we are calling on the name of God. That's why we are here, to ask of anything that we want from God. Amen. God's word assures us that if we are willing and obedient, he will forgive and remove every sin away from us. Amen. This is what the word of God says. So it's an assurance and it's an encouragement that we shouldn't run away from the presence of God. Instead, in his presence, there's fullness of joy. In his presence, there's a reasoning together with him. Amen. Even in this time of separation, as we are looking at the theme, at separation, we have to come to him. Even as we are in separation, it is the willingness and the obedience that will determine. That is the most important thing. Amen. So we just want to pray today that, Lord, help us, you know, to have a willing heart to do the will of God. And then the obedience as well. We need to be obedient to what God is calling us for. We need to be obedient with what God wants us to do. Amen. In this time where we are, there's a lot that is happening, and people have chosen to do different kinds of things. But our faith and our hope is in God. That's where we can find rest. That's where we can find the answers. That's where we can find anything that we are looking for. Amen. So we shall hold hands this afternoon, even as we are breaking the fast. We hold the hand that, Lord, help us to have a willing heart. Help us to do your will, Lord. Help us to obey you in this moment. Let us just pray and just lift the name of the Lord on high. Amen. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise this afternoon. We give you the adoration because you are Yahweh. We give you the adoration because there's no any other God apart from you. We thank you, Father, even for the invitation that you are calling us into your presence, oh God. Father, we thank you that you are Yahweh, oh God. You are the only one who can help us, oh Father. We thank you, Jehovah God, even in this time as this, oh God. We've got our Father. We've got our God. We've got our Helper. Father, we thank you that you are a faithful God, that you shall never leave us nor forsake us. You are Yahweh, Lord. You are the one who is watching over us. You are the one who is giving every provision for us. Father, we thank you, Jehovah God. We look up to you, Jehovah God, the finisher and the perfecter of our faith. You are mighty, oh God. You are just, oh God. A God of faithfulness without injustice is who you are. Father, we thank you, Lord. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. Yahweh, you are Yahweh. There's nothing that is too hard for you. There's nothing that you have failed, oh God. Even as we are going through this moment, at the moment, we are going through a lot of things. Father, we pray that you are the only one who can comfort us. We give you praise, Lord. We give you the honor. You are Yahweh. You are mighty. Father, we depend on you. You are the King of Kings, the glory of God. Father, we thank you that you are our faithful God, that you are our anchor, that we shall depend on you, oh God, that you are calling us, oh God, to do your will, oh God. Father, you are calling us, oh God, to uplift your name on high, oh God. Father, we thank you that you are Yahweh, that you are Jehovah Jireh, the Holy One of Israel. Thank you, Father, for your goodness. Thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. You are Yahweh. Father, there's nothing that you have failed, and there's nothing that you can fail. Father, we worship you. We uplift your name on high, Lord. We uplift your name on high, Lord. Be glorified, Jehovah God. Be glorified, oh God. Be magnified even in every situation, oh God. Be our Father, oh God. Be our anchor, oh God. We call upon you, Yahweh. We call upon you, King of Kings. We call upon you, Jehovah Jireh. Father, we thank you that you are our Father, that we depend on you, oh God. You are worthy of our praise, Jehovah God. We thank you, Father. Anything, everything that we need is found in you, Jehovah God. Yeah. Father, we pray, Lord, that, Lord, you may direct our path, oh God. Father, watch over us, oh God. Guide us, Jehovah God. We thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for your healing upon our lives. Thank you, Lord, for touching our souls, oh God. Father, we want to worship you. We want to give you the praise for even inviting us, oh God. We don't deserve all this, Jehovah, but because your faithfulness and the love that which you have for us, Jehovah Jireh, you are Yahweh. You are mighty, oh God. There's nothing impossible with you, oh God. Father, we want to worship you. We want to give you praise, oh God. We want to exalt your holy name because you are Jehovah Jireh, because you are Yahweh, oh God. You are our Father, oh God. You never leave us nor forsake us, Lord. You always watches over us, Lord. You are always concerned about our welfare, oh God. Father, we thank you. We give you the praise, Lord. We uplift every church member, oh God, at this time, Lord. Father, we pray every prayer petition that they've asked, Lord. Father, we thank you that you are more than able to answer us, oh God. Father, you are more than able, oh God. You have done it for us, Lord, and you have done it before, oh God. And you are going to do it, oh God, and you are doing it, Father. Lord, we worship you. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Jehovah God, that you are mighty, oh God, that you are the throne, or you're seated on the high throne, oh God. Father, we want to worship you. We want to uplift your holy name, oh God. You are Jehovah Jireh, the Holy One of Israel. Father, we thank you. May your name be glorified. Jehovah God, we worship you. Jehovah God, we thank you. You are mighty, oh God. Father, we thank you. You are Yahweh, oh God. Thank you, Father. Thank you that you are doing it for us, Lord, that you are doing it for everyone, Lord. Father, we want to worship you. Do not pass us by, Lord. Father, we thank you. Even as when you are blessing others, Lord, bless us, oh God. Father, we thank you. We give you the glory, oh God. We give you the honor, oh Father. We give you the praise, oh Lord. Father, thank you for being with us, Lord. Thank you, Jehovah God, even for this vision of prayer and fasting. Lord, we pray that, Father, we have come to seek your face, oh God. How pleasant and good it is, oh God, oh Master, to just dwell in your in unity, oh God, to dwell in your presence, oh God. And Father, there you bestow a blessing. Father, may your name be glorified. We worship you, Lord. You are Yahweh, Jehovah. You are mighty, oh God. You are worthy, oh Father. We thank you, Jehovah God. We come to you just as we are, oh God. Father, we thank you. We exalt your holy name, oh God. Father, Lord, or Master, what can separate us from the love of God? Not even anger or hunger, no. Lord, we thank you. We pray that, Lord, because you are our Father, you are our everything, Lord. We depend on you, Jehovah God, and you are able to give us, oh God. Father, we thank you. We give you praise, oh God. May your name be glorified. May your name be glorified, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Father, even when we are feeling low in our bodies, in our spirits, Jehovah God, Father, we thank you that you are the one who's giving us strength, oh God, to carry on, oh God, to forge ahead, Jehovah God. Father, we thank you. We worship you, Lord. You are mighty, oh God. You are all powerful, Lord. We don't need any other helper, God. You are the one, Jehovah God, our maker. Father, we want to worship you, the firm foundation, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we want to worship you. We give you the praise. We give you the glory, Lord. You are Yahweh. We thank you, Jesus. We give you the praise, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You, Lord. We worship you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
The last verse that I'm going to share is in the book of 1 Samuel. First Samuel chapter 1. I'll be jumping some of the scriptures. First Samuel chapter 1.
Sorry, woman of God, there is some feedback. Is there another logging of Zoom, another gadget logged on? Is Pastor nearby or is another room?
Yes.
Okay, bless you. Bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Go ahead, woman of God.
The other scripture I'm going to share, it's in 1 Samuel chapter 1. And starting from verse 4, Pastor Nkole, if you could just read for me, I'll just be asking you to read some of the verses as we go on.
1 Samuel chapter number 1.
Yeah, verses 9.
Verse 9.
Yes.
The Bible says, so Anna arose after they had finished eating and drinking in Shiloh. Now Eli the priest was sitting on the seat by the doorpost of the tabernacle of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed to the Lord and wept in anguish. Then she made a vow and said, O Lord, my God, God of hosts, if you will indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant and remember me and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child, then I will give him back to you, to the Lord, all the days of his life, and no razor shall come upon his head. And it happened, as she continued praying before the Lord, that Eli watched her mouth. Now Anna spoke in her heart, only her lips moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore Eli thought she was drunk. So Eli said to her, how long will you be drunk? Put your wine away from you. But Hannah answered and said, no, my Lord, I am a woman of soul of spirit. I have not drunk neither wine nor intoxicating drink, but I've poured out my heart before the Lord. Do not consider your maidservant a wicked woman. I continue?
Yes, Pastor, call up to verse 18, please.
Okay. For out of the abundance of my complaint and grief, I have spoken until now. And Eli answered and said, go in peace. And the God of Israel grant your petition, which you have asked of him. And she said, let your maidservant find favor in your sight. So the woman went away and ate, and her face was no longer sad. Amen.
Amen. I just loved Samuel, the book of Samuel, and the story of Hannah. She's a woman who was deeply distressed because of her situation, the things that she was going through. And she was praying, and the Lord answered her. You know, in life, sometimes you go through situations whereby they just leave us speechless. But even then, in the moment of the speechless, we shouldn't shun away from doing the good, the will of God. We shouldn't shun away from crying out to the Lord. Because God is the one who answers us. God is the one who gives us our heart's desire. Hannah prayed and the Lord heard him. Even the priest got mistaken of her because of the anguish, the way she was praying. She was deeply distressed within herself, within her spirit. She couldn't utter any words, but she was crying to God to say, Lord, if you could grant me the son, then I'll dedicate him to you. There are some of the things that we've been praying for. There are some of the things that we have asked God for. It has taken ages, it has taken years. We've also been, we can testify to these things. Every one of us has a testimony in one way or the other. We at some point, life just goes like, it's not making any sense. But that's not the time for us to stop worshiping God. That's not the time for us to stop crying to God. Hannah cried even in her distress. She continued looking forward to the blessing from the Lord. So even as we are here, we've got so many prayer requests that we have petitions, so many prayer requests that we have asked God to help us with, so many things that we are trusting God to help us in our areas of our lives. And this is a very good scenario. This is a very good example. But Hannah, she was always in the shrine, in the temple of the Lord. That's why the psalmist said, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. We shouldn't stop crying to God. We shouldn't stop doing the right thing. Hannah cried and the Lord heard him. Let us just pray. Let us just pour our hearts to God and just let us God to use us, even if it's crying, even if it's just sitting quiet and contemplating upon the goodness of the Lord. God searches our hearts. Let us just cry to him. Let us just pray. Let us just ask him to do what he wants to do in our lives. It is him who has everything. It is him who holds everything. Let us just pour out our hearts to him. Let us just separate ourselves and just go flat out for God. And let just him himself work in us, because we cannot do it on ourselves. Amen. Let us just pour ourselves. Let us just pour our hearts to him. Let us just pray. Pray. Forget about the neighbor. Pray. Forget about anything that is happening. I know when you are going through a situation, even if the word of God is being preached, even if an encouragement comes, sometimes we miss it because we are so much focused on the problem, which is at the moment. But Hannah, here's a very good example. She cried. She was in the temple crying to the Lord with her situation. Let us just pray. Let us just ask God that, Lord, in your mercies, we've all have got our different prayer requests. Father, let us just pray. Let us just pray. Pray, even if it's lying on the floor, even if it's crying, even if it's jumping, even if it's shouting, even if it's screaming, our God is able. God is able to touch us. Father, we thank you. We want to give you praise. We want to exalt your holy name. We want to thank you that you are Jehovah Jireh. Father, we thank you for the work that you have done in us, for the things that you have promised us. Father, for all the things, the good things that are yet to come. Father, we pray and we thank you that you are our God, that you are our Father. You are mighty, O God. You are mighty in all your ways, O God. We pray, Jehovah God, that even as we are wrapping up the prayer and fasting, Lord, you know our hearts. Search our hearts, Lord, and know our anxieties. Lord, we thank you. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. You alone are mighty. You alone are Yahweh. You alone are Jehovah Jireh. You know our harsh desires, oh God. You know our failures, oh God. You know our weaknesses, oh God. You know my heart's cry, oh God. You know my need, oh God. You know my desire, oh God. You know my dreams, oh God. Father, Lord, I thank you. I give you praise for my life, oh God. I give you praise for my children's life, oh God. I give you praise for all the Warwick Church, Lord, for their lives, oh God. Father, I bring each one of you, Father, in your presence, oh God. Father, I pray, Jehovah God, that every prayer that has been petitioned, every prayer request that have been petitioned, Lord, you are able, Jehovah God. Lord, you are able to answer us, oh God. Father, we thank you, Jehovah God. We pray to you, Jehovah God. We ask of your blessing, oh God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You are mighty, oh God. You are worthy, oh God. You are worthy, oh God. You are worthy, oh God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. If you need to text James, if you need to text Mark, Lord, we thank you.
Pour out your blessings upon us, mighty God, as we cry to you, mighty God, as we cry to you, mighty God. Ire keria kandra baba baba baba. Keria kandra baba. Kara baba baba. Ramaria kandra baba. Father, we give you the praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you honor, mighty God. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. Oh, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. Ekriya kandra baba. Oh, we give you the praise. We give you the glory. Mighty God, we cry to you. You are a faithful God. 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 Mighty God, mighty God, we pour out our hearts before you, Lord. Oh, mighty God, we need healing, oh God. We need your hand of protection, oh God. We need your hand of protection, oh God. We glorify your holy name. We give you the praise. We give you glory. We pour our hearts to you, oh God. Only to you, mighty God. Whatever we may be going through right now, Father, we pray. Have your own way. Have your own way. Have your own way. Have your own way. Have your own way, mighty God. 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 Oh, we give you the praise. We give you the glory. Have your own way. Have your own way, mighty God. Have your own way, King of Kings. Hallelujah. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you honor. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you praise. Father. We give you glory, mighty God.
Our God, you are powerful.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the
love and you
we give you the
love.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, we know how much you said our power.
Hallelujah. How give you the praise. Hallelujah. Jesus is mighty. Jesus is mighty. Hallelujah. Father, we pray. We pray. We pray. We pray. We pray. Mighty God. We pray. Mighty God. Pray, mighty God. Pray, mighty God. Mighty God. Pray, mighty God. You alone. You alone. You alone. You alone. You alone. Alone. You alone. You alone. And we pray.
Over to you, Pastor Corley.
Amen and amen. Let's just give